And welcome back to some Morganum Online, UC0096, with me, Polar Dash. This is a Shangri-La server with Mr. Polar. The map is Abelaku Interior, which is funny, because I'm pretty sure in 0096, Abelaku is, like, no longer existent. But I guess trying to relate this game and, like, comparing it to the actual show was stupid, too, because no. Bring in these guys, because their veterancy isn't very high. It's the only reason. Just point out with all my, suits in the bottom of the list, the veterancy list. Because leveling it up gives you money. Money is good now, considering, gold blueprints. If you want to go down this way. Cost 5 million GP to purchase. Yep. Oh, the Shin Matsunaga though. I switched its beam cannon or its beam rifle to type N. It previously carried the type M for its longer range, better accuracy. Stop shooting me, stop shooting me with your fucking beams. Oh, damn it. But the type N, for a slight reduction in all those categories, it's a, holy god, significant damage boost to the damage on the beams, which is important because the beams don't do a whole lot of damage to begin with. Diamonds. Dead gunner. Dead gunner. Oh, really? I missed that? Wow. I'm not pro on my Norisaku like Uncle P. He runs four because he's really into the pink. I just said something that made me laugh because I am in the third grade. No. Have I killed anything? I killed two dudes. Okay. So I thought we were on the losing end, but it looks like the Federation has got the shorter stick. Bar, gauge, you know, length of blue tape, whatever them things up there look like to you. Hey. Nope. Hi, Gundams. No. I thought that guy ran all the way back to, like, his mommy base, but he came back. So I turned around. Because I just expect Gundams to be pussies. So, yeah, them having five is bad. Try to go around by using the hole. But the hole wasn't good enough. What do I do in this situation? Yeah, dinner is coming back up in my throat. It's gross. Get here. So that was unnecessary amount of info. I don't care. Oh. Come back. those. You're anti-beam coding piece of shit. That guy still lives. Say, more damage. More damage is good. That sniper asshole, though. Nope, we're gonna hide from him. You thought I was gonna say something crazy like, outsnipe him with my long-range automatic beam rifle. That's for dumb people. It's not for Shin Matsunaga. Shin Matsunaga was just given a long-range automatic beam rifle for, I don't know, quartermaster reasons. That's all they had. Shin Matsunaga was all like, just give me another sword. They're like, we don't have another sword. We got this beam rifle though. It's high powered, it's long range. But you know, long range skirmishy combats. But that would bring dishonor to Shin Matsunaga family. So he uses it like a close range submachine gun weapon. And I'm talking stupid again. The enemy aren't, they're not coming down, so we're just gonna leave. Shin Matsunaga's getting bored. There's a guy up there. Hold on. Hold that Thought Gundam up there. Let me kill you. Oh! Damn it. Yeah, Shin Matsunaga is like, this is whole shit. This is dumb. Getting- Oh god! Sorry, dude. He's got like stern pulse and dumbness. Oh god! Bye bye. This map has gotten super campy lately, like since like 3 months ago. Kind of sucks. It used to be rampant craziness, people rushing in and out of flags and stuff, and trying to push into bases and stuff like that. But no, that was some yesteryear ago. And times in Boku were cool. Because that time existed. Looks like the Federations are doing something. In the center. Nuke. It's got his damn. Yeah. Stand lost. Wait, I'm going the wrong way. Took the wrong way. Kite up by the stupid Gundam. Oh! We got the nuke though. Nothing to do with Shin Matsunaga. It's okay. Oh, now they're taking. Stuff is happening, and Shin Matsunaga's not there because his freaking recall is horrendously long. Yeah. Dude, I've never seen so many. I've never seen so many mines in the center of this place in my life. Look, oh, watch. Look. That didn't destroy any. He's like, holy shit! That was funny. Repair guys with like ammo things, no. That would have been useful. Ugh. The Galax takes Shin Matsunaga's kill. That's our no gun. That's school stick. This is me stuck in the middle. Hey, look, there's a useless support guy. It's coming. Oh. Made our points. I hate reconnaissance, Zaku. I have one, but it's yet to be touched, because I just don't like them. Because it's a shame they bring to this game in Xeon. So they're gonna come down here eventually? I see dots moving. But you're scaring them away with your glow stick. I'll follow you. Oh, fuck, look it down. You wanna not lock? This way. I got butterfly wings. Oh my god. Just got Norris'd. Good. I got better moves than you, because I'm Norris. The guard! Oh fuck, I'm out of... I'm out of bazooka rounds. I missed his twin repair gun like a pro. That's gonna be like so embarrassing. That's why I'll never fly one. I'll never use twin repair gun. I'm afraid of missing and looking like a fool. That guy was playing around. Bad time to play around. Oh fuck! Good job, Gundam. You just. I don't know what the hell you did. Stop it. You're embarrassing yourself. This might not kill it. No. Right there, grenade type M would have been super handy, but Mr. Polar's 2F2 rocket shooter trait is not sufficiently upgraded. I had to make weight considerations, so he is without grenades. For whatever reason, the 2F2's machine guns are heavier than everybody else's. Kind of makes no sense. Okay. Oh, that was a perfect shot, too. Let's go with Johnny. Come on. Everybody. Come on. Come to Ghetto. VG is a Thundercat. Yeah. Do this with the VG. Whoa! No repair stations up yet. Really? hitting the guy. Where's our repair station? Where's our repair station? It's like way back there. Oh, I lost my shield though. Fighting in this doorway. It's stupid. Just opening and closing like some kind of creepy Gundam peep show. No. Bad. Backed up into a stupid Tetra. F2 would have been a better choice, but the card needed to engage the Gundams. Okay. Best way is, they're still dropping grenades down here, or not grenades, but that other thing that are like grenades, but pancake shaped. Stand up for the victory, guys. Come on. Go. And there. Really? These guys are falling back like the biggest pussies. Guy back here? Nah. There's like a healing. Oh, what's happening? Oh, Kai is happening. What's back here? You a Gundam? You're not? Was it around yet? Let's go this way, guys. Go. Alright, watch up. Watch up the mines. Shoot the mine, Norris. That's alright. I bought seconds for the Dom. It's rushing toward base C, which is like never touched. Good. No Zaku Mine Layer mines. Left there. Never do anything, because Zaku Mine Layer is stupid. Unfortunately. Ah, fudge! Shelter. What is that crazy sound? Ah!
Dude, blob of death heading this way.
Okay. Yes! Second life! You're friendly. Ah! Go, 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 go! For Zeon's glory! Seek!
Months ago, I couldn't get the last stab on that stupid. Whatever that was, the Diaz. But we win! Aboku saved, even though it looks like we just blew up one of the reactors. Yay! That stuff. Yeah. My level 4s are leveling. Gotta get it to level 8 to get me 50k. The long ways. But yeah, his beam rifle, the damage difference was noticeable, like hugely. So this is dealing 118 points of damage per shot, this is dealing 136. It's only like an extra 20-ish. But then you add beam shooter level 3, which is another 10%, so it's like 136 plus another 13, so that's like 149. So that's about 150 damage per shot, which is the default value for most fully automatic beam rifles type N. Like, Well, that it used to be. That's right, Shin Matsunaga's beam rifle wasn't buffed for whatever reason, everybody else was. It used to be 1500, but they buffed it by 200 points. To give it 170 default. But Shin's beam rifle has a faster rate of fire than these guys. So he's dealing damage faster, which is probably the reason behind it not dealing as much damage as the other rifles. But it's still stupid though, because Shin is a heavy class, and he's not getting kind of like heavy class damage bonus on his beam rifles. But it doesn't change the fact that I was killing things, but I wish this thing was buffed. Like maybe just maybe like by like 50 extra points or something. Like he has a type F. And it's probably because of this thing that this rifle is not getting buffed, because type F at the same rate of fire deals 150 damage base. And you upgrade this to, I think it upgrades to 165, right? Then you have beam shooter to that, so it's like dealing like 180-ish damage per shot. But I only got 50 rounds, and its accuracy is horrendous. 800 accuracy is super bad. 800 accuracy is like, I don't know, like bazooka accuracy? Bazooka's even more accurate. Not a type F, but like 800 is like piss in the morning. Like seriously, it's just beams go everywhere. But yeah, because if you're gonna upgrade the damage on these things, you have to evenly upgrade the damage on this guy. But it could be potential game breaker. I don't know. I still wish this thing would deal more damage. Because then it'd be even more super awesome. This thing. Still can't find a use for this thing. I've been running a lot of suits a lot like the Gyarados because the Gyarados is great with his two grenade launchers, and you know, this thing has a grenade launcher too, Undersun grenade launcher. I'm using the bazooka as a replacement to the shield grenade launcher that the Doga gets, but it's just, you know, the switch time. There's a switch time involved. It's too slow. And it's direct fire, it's not arcing. What's that word? What is that word? Not favorably, but I can't think of the word. Tip of my tongue. Whatever. It'd be great if I can, you know, like, do this, and then this, and then I could insta-switch to the beam rifle. See, the Gyaradoga, preferably, ideally, was the word I was looking for. Like, in the ideal situation, right, you're going this to this, and switch to this to finish off. And then if he's being dodgy, once another round cycles back into the chamber, you can insta-switch back to the grenade launcher to pop the finisher, the kill shot off. But yeah, the problem with the Gyaradoga was that his beam rifle doesn't do any damage. What was this guy? The vegetable Gyalgoog's beam rifle does a lot more damage than the Gyaradoga's. Does damage faster. So it doesn't need to rely, go back to like the twin grenade launchers to continue dishing out damage. You can just continue to deal damage with this thing. But yeah, just too slow. Too slow. Although, this thing also can get the quick switch trait, which might make switching to the grenade launcher or to the bazooka faster. I think Uncle P has one. And he's all like raving over his quick switch VG Gyalgoog because he's crazy. But maybe you can try it out, Uncle P, and try bazooka to grenade launcher to full auto beams. See if that works out for you. Uncle P's crazy. He's like, he has like all the heavy weapons loaded and he completely overburdens his Gyalgoog and just spams death weapons. Well, I guess what the VG would consider its death weapons, like it's like four-shot grenade launcher or rocket missile launcher thingy that it gets in its gold print. It's super heavy. But with quick switch, you can do like that, and then like get the bazooka type F, and then get grenade launcher type F, and just like switch between all these explosive weapons for potential funsies. But this thing is silver print, so we won't have those funsies. Maybe in the future, sometime, I'll get a gold print of this thing. And then we might be able to have funsies with lots of explosive boom booms, but that won't be for a while. All right, see you next time. Bye.